man. This is rock nose.
Not only are we doing this for the foundation, but we're breaking down the walls between East and West, and we're bringing rock and roll to Russia.
You know, Russian kids are really excited about this. Probably it's going to be like an explosion.
When the tickets went on sale, there was a line of something like 4 or 5 miles long for the tickets, you know.
Even if we played the 25 people, I mean, we're in Moscow, man.
Да, это впервые такой у нас фестиваль проводится.
No, they're just here to rock. It's everyone's 8 hours or however long this takes of freedom.
It's going to be a serious bash.
It's fantastic. I've never seen anything like it here.
It is like the Woodstock of Russia. This time, you know, I think what we're doing is so historic and so exciting that I'm going to get it all on videotape, so when it all goes by me and I'm blur, I can watch it back again, because it's quite the event.
Messages, just enjoyed the show. Russia, it was always an ambition of mine to go to Russia, and I couldn't think of a better way to come to Russia than with a big bang. What my personal views are is the fact that through this foundation, it's opened the door for music. I only hope this is the beginning of something great and big and wonderful for Russia. It would be so nice. It's a beautiful country, it really is. It's just the people in it are so miserable. I mean, they've got nothing. What it does make me appreciate is what we have in the West. I mean, that you can't get toilet paper here, you can't get toothbrushes here, you can't get toothpaste, you can't buy soap. Everything's rationed. You see lines for... I saw a great big line of people yesterday as we were driving in, for a cabbage, you know. I mean, that's ridiculous in this day and age. I mean, I think it's very sad, you know. They don't have McDonald's here, they don't have pizza delivery. That's a luxury, and we always complain. The guy said he would be here in 25 minutes. It's now been 35, and he hasn't arrived yet. They're still waiting for their pizza to be delivered, you know.
Where's that?
When Woodstock happened, it was all sort of peace and love and smoke pot and get high. We've been getting a bad rap for so long about encouraging people to get stoned and get drunk and all this. Well, since that 20 years has happened, a lot of people have died, you know, and we all realize you'll always get people who are going to drink, you'll always get people who are going to take drugs. But all we're trying to do here is make people aware that, you know, it's not a cool thing to get too crazy with it, you know.
God bless you, man.